This time, rather than having the trays, even though we have two little trays here, we talked about putting the herbs in little bags. Usually, if the herbs are kind of fine, I'd recommend a flannel type of bag. But these are little fancier bags. Again, you can make them into sachets. We talked about 2 weeks ago, actually, putting beads on them and doing different things. So the first bag that I'm going to do is a bag filled with, it's called wormwood. And of course, last week everything was out, so it was a lot easier to see. I'm gonna open these bags, and I have a black skirt on, which is probably gonna look like a herbal city here. But this is wormwood. And again, a lot of these herbs I'm gonna be showing you are gonna deal with protection. They're going to deal with romance, health, money, again, protection. And this first one, wormwood, is about protection. And what a lot of people do is they take this. You can put it four corners of your room. You can put it under your bed. But you can also put it in a white bag, which I've done here. Put it in a white bag. And, of course, this bag's a little big. They have smaller bags. This just happens to be what I have. Put it in a smaller bag. And you can tie it around your rearview mirror. Again, a smaller bag, you don't want to obstruct your vision. But just have it hanging from your rearview mirror, and it's said to protect you from car accidents. Again, this is called wormwood. I believe, now I've bought this in the Botanica, but I believe you could probably buy it in you could buy it probably in a New Age store, but even some of the health food stores carry a variety of herbs. And, you know, some of them are more roots, some of them are the leaves. But this is, again, called wormwood, and it will protect you if you put it in a white bag. And, again, they say a white bag. It's white, blue, too. Blue could probably be very good because blue is protection for travelers. Put it in a smaller bag, though, and put it around your rearview mirror, and that should help protect you from car accidents. The next one is Queen of Meadow. And let me open it up here. Back. Get this. Queen of Meadow. This is, again, and a lot of them multifaceted. As you can see, it's very, very fine. Very, very fine powder. And a lot of people use this for gambling. So again, with these type of bags, if it's really, really fine, it might go through the bag. So again, stick with cloth. I just happen to have it in this gold color bag. Gold is good, but if you're going to be doing gambling, you might want to put it in a green bag. Some people might burn a green candle because green involves money prior to, let's say, you know, going to a casino. Or even if you're trying to attract money, you might want to take a piece of virgin parchment paper or something and write down maybe the amount of money that you need. Put it in a bag, preferably a green bag. But gold is good too. Gold is a very good bag. So you could do that and just tie it. Again, the bags could be smaller. And you don't need a lot. You really don't need a lot. And the next one I have is Slippery Elm. And I'm pretty sure you can get this in any health food store. This is very, very fine, so that's why I have it in a plastic bag here. And Slippery Elm, again, is very powerful. It's one of those that are in the protection group. And again, you could sprinkle it in your bath. Some people would sprinkle it, could put it in your pillowcase. I'm the one that's very strong about having a mirror over your headboard, over your bed. So when you're sleeping, when you're very vulnerable to psychic attacks, it will send it back. So you might have it, you could attach a little tiny little bag to the mirror so you can have it with it. But Slippery Elm is a very, very good herb. And again, so many of these are for protection. Now, you can mix certain herbs and you can do little potions and stuff, but that's not what this show is about, and I'm not going to be going into that. But and if you do make these little like almost making a little dish or something, you know, the contraption or cooking. It doesn't mean that you're doing Santeria. It doesn't mean you're doing witchcraft. So, you know, it's nothing. These are just herbs. They're from the ground. They're natural. There's nothing. But they do have magical qualities of protection, and it's a wonderful thing to utilize it. Now, in this lavender bath, I have, it's called blackberry, and I like putting it in lavender because lavender is a spiritual color, also a protection color. And since blackberry is a sacred herb, I decided to put it in the purple bag. I'm taking it out here. I got big hands. So, you know, the TV makes you always look bigger. Trust me, my hands are this big. So, if you look at the, hopefully you can get a picture of this. This is blackberry. And these, I think, are like fine leaves of the blackberry, up and down. And I get it's a sacred herb used in a variety of spells, protection, gambling, and the only thing you use caution with this is because if somebody wanted to, somebody was mad at somebody and lost their head a little bit and wanted to do something negative, this herb could be used for that. So again, I'm not going to go into it. It's a good herb, but like positive things can sometimes be used for negative. And this is one of those herbs that could be used for negative. Because it's a sacred herb, it's very powerful. And want to use it just for good things, not bad things. So that's blackberry. The other one, and I'm sure people are familiar with the name of this, is called rue. I'm going to be opening this. Make sure these get nice and tight so things fill out for them. All kinds of things all over the studio here. And rue can be made into a tea. A lot of people make it into a tea. And it also can be used in a bath. The smell isn't too bad. The smell here, I believe they put it in cooking too, but it gives you mental balance and it helps you stay focused. So it's good for that balance if you're going to take a test or you've got a lot of studying to do or you're working on a project that requires a lot of focus and attention. Using rue would be very, very good, and again, you could keep it with you. So if you need that balance and staying focused, rue is the herb for you to use. Okay, another one here. Now, this, I'm not going to get into the magical properties, but they do boil this, and they break it down, and they make it into a tea. And no, I never have it. So some of these herbs I've had and some I haven't. But this is called cat's claw. And it's like a bark. And they break it down and they boil it probably for several hours. My mic here's working. Sound like it went off. And as I say, it's a very soothing tea. It also helps with arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and probably other joint and ache pains. So I think it does work with the bones. Again, this is, every herb usually has a medicinal quality with it, as well as a magical, but again, this is no medical claims or anything, so, you know, I'm not saying that, but I'm just, you know, you can go into health food stores and they'll have all different herbs, and we do know that years ago, before we had all our great medicines of today, we used herbs. And that's how our forefathers dealt with pain and other things, colds.